Sunday, I was going through, I had to polyurethane the washboard, the board, the wood to keep it, because the shells kind of eat up the wood a little bit, so I do that. And this is a new one that I had painted about 6 months ago, and I had just had it in the box just to let it dry and get hard. And I took it out Sunday, and just in moving it around, it had some tone. There was something different about it. So I started touching it, and I discovered that there's another way of playing a washboard. And so I want to share this little bit with you. And just imagine, the washboard has been like a connection to an ancestors for me. My paternal grandfather was born a slave in that, and it isn't because of washboard directly, but since I started playing this, it has I felt this connection. The first time I played it, I had to play it with Edna Hillbillies, with Warren Sullivan, and I had to play it with no rehearsal, not knowing the music, and not having played the washboard. And so I was going to put it on the stand. It wouldn't stay on the stand. It was time to play, so I just put it in my lap. I didn't even decide to do it this way or that way. I just put it in my lap, put the shells on, and listened to music and started to play. And it was such a magical experience. It was a combination of the ancestors, but also the washboard I was playing was a washboard that I had, I kind of took over, because when Evelyn Blakey, who was the oldest child of Art Blakey, and I was helping clean out her apartment, and I found this washboard. And it was old, it had been used. And I know she had washed her clothes, and I'm sure she washed Art Blakey's clothes on it too. So I took it and kept it for 3 or 4 years, not knowing what I was gonna do. I was just keeping it. And this thing with the Ebony Hillbillies came up. So that's what I used. And so the first time I'm playing this washboard, the first time I'm playing washboard, all of these things came together. But it became this magical moment where I was watching my hands do stuff. I don't know how they knew to do it. It worked with the music, and it was like the ancestors. Something else was coming through me and making this music. And so, further down the road, 5 years later, I picked this up, and I started hearing this, and I just imagined that how on the plantation, there were no cars, no airplanes, no electrical motors running, so it was really silent. So this kind of sound was much louder than it is for us now. But I started tapping, and I could just see people dancing and how they had to take whatever was available. And this is one thing, I like that sound, so they can do it. And you'd have to remember that the slaves were all mixed up from different cultures from Africa. Traditionally, there were drum families who only married drum families because the king, the chief's drummers, were special, and they married within the family. So these slaves were brought over, and I can imagine somewhere that some cat that's family was, he's in that drum family, has this thing for playing. And so he hears this sound and said, well, I could use this. And this is kind of what happened to me Sunday. Dances. If you move, it'll help us.